Yo guys, Em here, and welcome to the second farming diary. Now, we are back at Sosnovka, and I'm going to continue with my my farming exploits here. But before I do, I've actually travelled over to the little settlement area because today is Halloween, and if you've played the game on Halloween, you will have noticed that the residents and pedestrians are wandering around like zombies.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, I'm saying hello to a zombie. Right, yes, it's a little bit weird, but yeah, quite a nice Easter egg actually in the game, and as you can see, all of the residents are wandering around like zombies. Yes, brains. Let's, yeah, that's quite enough of that. Right, anyway, I just wanted to show you that because it's quite a fun Easter egg that they put into the game. So let's get back to the farm, and I've parked my truck just over here. Let's make sure I didn't get run over. Or even being virtually run over, it's not a good thing. So let's get back to the farm. This particular episode, we're going to look at some planting, maybe some fertilisation as well. So let's head back to the farm down there. Always remember your turn signals. And also today, it is Halloween, but also today they released the patch 1.02, which I believe will probably stop the money glitch, and also ups the slot number so you can actually purchase more equipment. So that's quite useful. I think it also fixed a number of other bugs as well in that release. So yes, anyway, let's head back to the farm. I haven't actually purchased a lot since the last video. However, what I have been doing is, well, I've been on a bit of deforestation, I will admit. I have been trying to take away some of the trees, and I'll show you that in just a moment. And there's the farm. Now, here we are, we're back at the farm. Now, as you may notice here, there is something I've put in the middle. Let's just get out and have a look. Now, in the last episode I showed you I had this conveyor belt for the wood chippings. Now, I have been going around, as you can see, being very, very busy, chopping down a lot of trees. And actually, the wood chipping is a little bit more satisfying, seeing as you can actually lift things up and throw them in by hand. The biggest problem I used to have with that was all the glitches when trying to pick things up. But anyway, I have these conveyor belts here, which is used for the wood chippings. Now, I have been creating so many wood chippings, chopping so many trees down, that I actually got bored of driving all the way down there to drop off the wood chipping, so I came up with a temporary solution, albeit not very realistic. I have placed this particular conveyor belt just at the right spot so that when it loads with wood chippings, they fall down directly into this burner and I earn a little bit of money. And I can probably just quickly demonstrate that, because I can see that there is a little pile of wood chips still in there. So let's go and find the the loader, so we can actually pick some up in a bucket, and we can then put that down. And I quite like this particular JCB, actually. I used to like the New Holland, but with this one with the double wheel set, actually I think it looks quite nice. I do quite like this. I'm not sure that's a door that side, but not that it really matters, but that's definitely a door, so let's get inside. Okay. Let's just go and scoop some of this up, and I can show you what happens. As you can see, I've cut all the trees down that were right next to that field as well. Sometimes the workers will get sort of stuck on those. Right, so what we're going to do here, I'm just going to move these this pile of wood chips a little bit closer, because as you can see, they're not being picked up. But as soon as I do that, they're going to probably get picked up by the scoop over there on the conveyor belt. Let's just dump them. Switch this off, get out, and there you go. You see, there they go, up the conveyor belt and straight down into there, and as you can see, I'm earning a little bit of money. So as I've been going around this farm chopping down all the trees, I've been throwing them in here and letting it sort it out and sell it. Now that's quite a smart way to operate, but a little bit unrealistic, and I do intend to actually remove this placeable item in the near future once I have actually decided to stop chopping trees down. Now around on the other side there is a number that I still want to get rid of right now, right there on the other side. But for now we'll have a look at something else today, rather than me chopping down more trees. Now one of the things I want to look at, the fertilization in this game is a little bit different than it was before, and this particular game that I have set up here has got the three levels of fertilization. So if I just bring up the menu and have a look here, now I have three fields, 14, 19 and 23, and as you can see I've got canola, I've got soybeans, and number 19 is actually empty as far as I can remember. So if we have a quick look at the growth chart, as you can see it's been ploughed, number 19, but there isn't anything in it. 23 is ready to harvest and number 14 is still growing. And if we just take a look at soil composition now, as you can see, 23 has yet to be harvested, so that now says that it needs to be ploughed. Well, obviously once it's been harvested, and number 14 has already been fertilized a couple of times, and as you can see it's the second color of blue, and the crop has not finished growing just yet anyway. And number 19, well, that's freshly plowed and fertilized. So as far as I understand how you're supposed to do the fertilization, basically once you've plowed the field, you're going to need to come along and fertilize it for the first time. Then when you plant the seed, especially if you use a seeder that's already got fertilizer in it as well, you need to plant the seed and then fertilize again, and then somewhere in between the growth stages as the plant is growing and before it becomes ready to harvest, you'll need to fertilize a third time, and that should give you the best yield on the crops in question. But as you can see in this particular field, well, I don't actually have anything at all. So what we're going to do is we're going to plant something into this field, and I need to go and find a tractor. So let's wander back over here. Actually, I might just move this big beast because I don't want it in the way in here. But I notice there's some more wood chips there, I see. Yeah, okay. By the way, if anybody's wondering about the controls, they all seem to move about. You do still have a flashlight, but you have to press and hold R1 and press circle at the same time, and then you can actually use the flashlight. Yes, it's not obvious, it's not on the menu, so I did not know either. So let's just move this. Let's get this big piece of machinery out of the way. Now, I am a tidy worker. I do like to keep things tidy. And should anybody join me on a multiplayer game, please do note I will get very frustrated if you do not keep things tidy on my farm. Let's keep it realistic and let's keep it tidy. So that's my motto. So let's park this here. I'm just going to put the bucket like that and switch it off. Right. Okay, so let's leave this here. Now we have the big truck here. I've been using this one to transport lots of the wood chips back and forth. Quite useful for hauling that, but I want a smaller tractor for this one. So I'm going to need to go and find a smaller tractor. Now I do have quite a few in my shed, and probably more than I really ought to have, to be honest with you. Typically, actually, I quite like this one for seeding and ploughing, but I think we're going to go for something a bit different. So let's just wander across the road, because I think I left a tractor over here. Let's just go out here and try not to get run over by this vintage car. Yes, there's a tractor over here, and also the seeder is over here as well, so that's going to be useful. Right, so let's just let's go pick up the seeder, and let's get in the tractor. It's just over there, so the head turning is a bit slow, I will admit. Right, now This particular type of cedar just is a cedar. It doesn't have any fertilization option on it. It's just cedar. But obviously some of the bigger ones can do both at the same time. It's obviously beneficial. Always look both ways. Now then. Okay. Now I'm going to have to decide which particular crop to put into this one. It's fairly well lined up. A little bit over, go back a bit. Okay. We've got soybeans, I don't want to plant grass, wheat and barley. I think I'm going to actually start by doing some wheat, because the straw will certainly come in handy for both the cow shed and obviously for baling to make mixed ration as well. So I'm definitely going to be doing that. So let's plant a field of wheat here. So let's get this down, switch it on, away we go. Now, can you see the colour difference there? This is a lot lighter than the ploughed field around it. And it's not fertilised, so we can actually fertilise this again once I have finished putting this down. I've gone a little bit off there, so... You will notice if you use the cedar that's got the fertiliser on it, it will obviously put it down in a much darker colour. A particularly straight line, I will admit. Now, I think I'm actually going to employ a worker now, because, well, I can, I do have enough money, and it also probably end up with a bit neater job, so let me let a worker do this one. She can deal with that. So as you can see, the colour is a lot lighter than the fertilised field, and which means we can now come along and fertilise this for the second time. So, wandering through this bush, the quickest way for me at the moment, as my cow operation has not really got up to speed with slurry or manure, is to take this New Holland beast out and give this one a go. So let's get inside this. Now, I think I just need to fill up a little bit, so we'll just go and fill it up first, make sure it's full. It's very difficult to see out of this, I will admit. I'm just going to drive over here and pop next to the... Should be close enough. There we go. Almost full. Okay, now we're full. So let's go back to the field. Now I'm pretty certain that she will not have done enough right now in order for me to open this fully, as it is rather big. Has quite a big span. So for the purpose of this, what I'm actually going to do is move off to the side here, just so that I can do some fertilization as an example, while she continues to work easily in that field. Make sure we don't get it in the way of her. No, that should be fine. Okay, so now I'm going to fertilize it. Notice it now changes colour again, something it didn't used to do in the game. So now this is fertilised soon. So this is actually the third... I'll just stop there. This is actually the third level of fertilisation. If we just go back to the map, I don't know if you can see there. It's very difficult because, yeah, I just need to figure out how to move about. There we go. And I need to change the map back to soil composition. And I don't know if you can see there on the map on number 19, but as you can see, we have the light blue, which was the first fertilization. That was when it was ploughed, and then I fertilized it. And now that I've seeded, I have fertilized on top as well. Just this little bit here is where I have actually just been fertilizing. So as you can see, we're now on to the second stage of fertilization, and at some point during the growth before it finishes, we need to fertilize it for a third time. And that should, as far as I understand, give me the best possible yield for this particular crop. So that's the basic idea, and I'm just going to tidy up this line just before finishing, so that at least we've done this whole strip here. And there we are going through the bushes. Now, this kind of machine is very useful to begin with, especially at the first part of the game where you don't have a lot of manure or you don't have a lot of slurry to use, because obviously that is much better to use later in the game. It doesn't cost you money to refill, and it's a sort of byproduct of your operations anyway. So I would recommend using that later. But as you can see, the feeding trough's a little bit empty. I don't have any silage to fill it, feed them, or I haven't got the mixed ration going yet either. So they're a little bit hungry. They have grass, but not a lot else. They are depositing a small amount, and I'm sure there's a little bit in this tank as well, but there's not quite enough to fertilize fields just yet. So we need that operation to get going a little bit better. And while talking about animals, actually there's some very interesting useful stats actually on the menu that you can keep an eye on. Now, as you can see, I have got 10 cows, and the cleanliness is now currently at 80%. They have water, they have straw, they have grass, they're missing the silage and the power food, so I need to do the mixed ration for that. And productivity is only at 33%. Well, I'm not feeding them the right things, so it's not surprising that it's not actually at a very high level. And as you can see there, that's the next animal will be coming along in a very, very long time. So the animals will breed if they've fed well and they're looked after, so I need to get more food into them, and then they'll breed a little bit quicker than they currently are. Also, you need to keep the cleanliness obviously quite good. So it's currently green. It can get worse. The cleanliness for these animals really involves actually cleaning the feeding area where you put the grass in. And the reason I'm walking this way is because I know that I have my New Holland machine just over there. And what I wanted to show you is how to clean it. Now, you can scoop it up. You can use the blade to push it. But my preferred option, actually, which probably is the easiest way, is to use one of the foragers, such as this one, and use this head rather than the other head, so that you can actually pick up the spillage. So let's go and do that. I think this particular trailer is absolutely full though, but we can just go and empty some of the grass at the same time. But first, we need to get rid of this mowing head because I don't want this actually on the machine. So let's just move this. Let's put the mowing head here, that'll do. And let's just drop that. That's all the wrong way. I've got to go around the building. As you can see, the trailer is 93% full anyway. I've missed it badly. Oh, now, not to demonstrate hooking it up. Right. There we go. Right, we have that on. Let's head over to the feeding area. Which is just down this way. Now, as you can see, let's just switch this off for a second. I don't know if you can see that there, but what basically happens is the feeding trough seems to spill out extra grass, as you can see. And this is generally the cleanliness of the animal area, so you need to tidy this up, clean it up to keep the cleanliness at a high level. So, what we're going to do is we're going to take the machine and just run it over it. So let's just get in the machine, and the reason why I'm using this as opposed to a scoop, you could easily use one of the buckets and scoop it up, but I actually like this because this collection system actually picks it up off the ground. So, but before we actually try picking it up, what we're actually going to do as well is see if we can unload any more grass. It would appear not. Okay. I'm going to have to turn around the other way. These trailers are not helpful. Right, let's just turn this around. And I just need to put the pipe out. If I'm on the right machine. My bad. Right, now we've got the pipe out. And the easiest way I find it is just to use this, actually, because what will happen is this will pick up the excess and transfer it into the trailer. Move here. And I'm stuck between the fence. I didn't say I was a smart farmer. And as you can see, it's cleaned it up. Now, if we go back to the menu, you will see that it doesn't update immediately. It seems to be periodic. So don't be too worried if it shows the cleanliness has not improved back to 100% immediately, because it can take a little while for that to actually register. But this is the quickest and easiest way I've found to keep it clean. You can, of course, use the scoop in a bucket. It can take a little bit longer to do it. Obviously, you just scoop it up and put it straight back in. That's all you need to do each time. So that'll keep it nice and clean, and they'll be a bit happier. So let's now move this machine back, because we don't need any more grass here right now. I don't have enough cows otherwise. So let's just put this back, and I'm just going to put down that first. And let's just move this back over the other side where it came from. I must say, they've done some very good sampling of the sound here on the game. I do like the engine noises. They've done a very good job on this. Much better than the previous version. Okay, that'll do for now, I think. So, let's go see how well she's doing. Make sure I don't get run over. No cars. Now, as I understand it from a lot of the forums, Reddit, the official pages, there are some problems with these silos. Now, as you can see, I have not yet actually started filling up for silage, and I'm actually thankful I hadn't, because a lot of people have put a lot of good hours into filling these with silage, and then, they can't get the last bits out, because what actually happens is, as they empty the silage, bits of it actually end up underneath these concrete blocks, and, basically you can't actually quite get to them with the scoop. They're underneath. Now, one possible solution is to use a conveyor belt system, which obviously you can move in and it should pick it up off of the ground from a surrounding area. So it will obviously allow you to do that. However, that's a little bit frustrating. So I do hope that Giants come up with a solution there for that one, so that we can actually do silage properly, so we don't have to keep messing around trying to get out the last bits from the corners that we didn't have scooped out. So let's go see how well she's done. Let's take the New Holland so we can get a bit of view. And Dean, she's quite well. She's getting on quite well there. I think we can do another strip now with this. So why don't we put this over there? Now, I must admit, from an interior view, this is incredibly difficult to line up. I think it's the lack of depth. I think I might have just hit a tree. I did hit a tree. My bad. Okay, let's just go over here. See if we can do this. I'm not sure if that's going to be in her way. No, it's not going to be in her way. Now, I must admit, lining this up from the interior view is a bit tricky, but as you can see, it's not bad. That wasn't bad at all. I'm quite impressed with myself there. Right, so let's just do this big strip. Certainly not an easy game from the interior view, but it does add an extra bit of realism to the game. It certainly makes it a bit more of a challenge. Certainly a lot easier from outside than inside. So we're almost there. Not wasting. Okay, well that's another strip, and I guess now it's going to be a lot more obvious on the map that the area has been updated. Indeed, there you can see that 19 is definitely a lot changed in colour. So this is the second fertilisation, and then I've got to do the third one. So I don't think 14 can be fertilised yet, because I don't think enough time has gone since I planted it. However, we can go and have a look, and we can go and have a look at that and see what state it's in. While she continues with the last bit. And yeah, I've got to get rid of those trees over there. They do bother me. I don't like those trees. As you can see, it looks much nicer without the trees. Much lower. I mean, I can't like the trees in the distance. It's not all the trees. It's just those trees. They're just so... It's just so regularly placed and just so... It just doesn't look right. I have to rage a war on those and... deforest the whole area. It takes a long time, but maybe I'll set up a multiplayer game and get some helpers who like doing some logging. So as you can see, I have fertilized this, and it doesn't look as though it's ready for a second. No, it's not really ready for another fertilization yet. I think it needs to grow a little bit more before it can do any more fertilisation. I can just try, because the texture colours are so difficult to see. It can be very tricky to see if it's ready for another one. But I think it needs to grow at least a little bit more before I can apply the last fertilisation to that field. So let's just go back to the fertiliser. And oh dear, I can see I left a log here. Let me just put that somewhere obvious. I do like the fact you can carry things around. Oh, it must be Halloween. Strange things are happening. Put it there. There we go. All right. Yes, well, if you've done any logging in the farming game before, you realise that it has some interesting glitches. Yes, let's leave it at that. But they are much improved in this, the glitches at least. But there are some other problems. But I must admit, I was not as annoyed using the wood chipper as I did get before. Mostly because you can pick things up and throw them in by hand. And that's a lot easier to do than... than trying to use the grabber. So what I'm just going to do is move this up to make it a bit easier to drive, so we don't catch on anything. Right, let's just drive over to other field, but I'm pretty certain it's not ready yet for another fertilisation. In fact, I might actually go to the other end, because it's got a bit of a skewy end, this diagonal. Let's start with a square end. Definitely way off here. I think I'm still way off here. See how far it goes out. It's very tricky judging this, I must admit, but it does add an extra challenge. No, it doesn't look bad if I lower it a bit. It's not bad, it is way over, but let's just go over here. Back a little bit. That's about right, that's fine. Well, we can just see, but I think it's the same colour. We can just see. It looks the same colour to me. Let's just do a little bit and then check on the map. Let's just stop there and have a look. Indeed, it's the same colour, so it's not doing anything at all. So it needs to grow a little bit more before we can do anything else with this. I'll just extend the wheels here, because for no apparent reason, I just like doing it. Right, let's move this back over here. Make sure we don't get caught up on anything. And like I say, I try to be a tidy worker, so I'm going to put this back away for now. Although, actually no, because she has not finished, has she? So let's just go back this way. Well, I think we can do another slot. Okay, let's try. Open it out. A bit too far over. But I can see that's going to get in her way, so I'm just going to move back a second. She should then go past. At least I've got a good sized cup holder in here. Disappointingly empty though. Right. A bit close to her, but that'll do. Let's just do another strip here then. Let's switch it on. So, I mean, obviously you don't have to do the three levels of fertilization, and you can customize it as well on the settings to change it to be not three levels, but it's a little bit of fun, and actually makes a use of the fertilisation stages, which before was, well, you only needed to do it once, and that was really it. So she's almost done, let's just stop that. We can get out. Let's go over there. Have a look how she's doing. She's doing it a lot tidier than me. Especially one of the small seeders. Got a few strips to go there before the end, but generally she's a bit better than me at finishing it off. Something else I noticed in the game since playing it is they've done some different water effects, and there's a really nice reflection now, much better than the previous version. So they've done a good job there. I quite like that. It's adding some realism, and the shapes of the trees are different as well. Also making it a bit of a challenge when chopping down the trees. I can see I've got some more work cut out. Now, I had planned in my particular map to put on this particular field over here to actually put the greenhouses on this particular slot area, because Normally, well, in the previous game, you would obviously load it up with some manure to increase the output of the greenhouses. And in the previous game, there was no way of really adequately moving that around from place to place, or indeed tipping it anywhere else. So you could load it up into the trucks, but you could never really get it out of the trucks unless you were fertilizing a field. Nor could you really, really put it anywhere or use anything else to actually transport it about. So generally speaking, the closer the better for the greenhouses in the previous game. Now, I must admit, I originally was planning on the original game in my thoughts, and obviously this game is not the same. So what that basically means is that I could actually put it anywhere I like, because if we go to the shop and let's have a look at some of the tippers, for example. As you can see, pretty much all of the tippers will take everything, including manure. So you can obviously load them up on tippers, drive it somewhere, and because you've got the tip anywhere opportunity, you can obviously put it down anywhere you like. So that means that you don't have to have the greenhouses right next to your cow pasture. So I thought I was going to turn this particular area into greenhouses as I did before, because on this particular slot I had well, I had quite a few actually. I think I must have had about 20 on this particular area, all connected together, and utilized it all fully for getting the manure directly from that from over there by the cows straight into all of the different greenhouses. But obviously I'm not going to need to do that now, because I can obviously put it anywhere I like. So I need to rethink what I'm going to plan out here. I don't think I want to put the greenhouses right here now, because I think it'll be quite fun to put them somewhere else, and actually transport it back and forth, doing deliveries of manure. So I'm probably going to do that rather than actually build the greenhouses right next to the cow pasture. And if you're noticing there are some joins in between some of the clips here, that's because unfortunately I have to do that, because being on the PlayStation, it records 15 minutes at a time, and well, I have to keep interrupting it and saving them every so often, otherwise it'll just try and overwrite itself, and then it won't be any good, because then I can't record it. So that's why, if you notice any odd transitions or slight pauses, it's because I'm recording the different pieces together. So that's a little bit of a technical know-how there. And let's go see if she's almost finished now, so that we could actually finish this field. Now, the other thing we could do in this particular episode is actually do some harvesting, because over there is a field that is ready to be harvested. And let's see if she's close enough for me to do another strip. Otherwise, we'll leave it till a little bit later. And it looks like she's not quite finished yet, so I think we'll leave that for her to be a bit later. So I now need to make a very long trek over to the combine, which is in that shed at the end. So let's make our way over there. And this is obviously gonna start growing. I believe crops take longer to grow this time. I've certainly noticed it with the grass, the wild grass. You harvest it and it takes longer to grow before it starts actually getting like this kind of grass. So it seems to take longer for most things, but that's okay, because it's actually easier to focus on lots of other things. So let's take this lovely big combine out and let's do some combining in this particular field here. So let's take the big New Holland out. I'm gonna need to connect up to the header. So let's get it going first. Okay, big machine this. Get it out. Yeah, the only problem is the mirrors aren't really helping me here, I think. I think I can see it just there. But I'm not sure if that's lined up. It was actually kind of lined up. Not bad. Okay, let's just take this out. I can't see, of course, but I'm looking in that mirror. Okay, now we've got it. I'm gonna have the header in the wrong place now, so that's not gonna help. go over here. Okay. Okay, let's unfold the machine. Top's coming open. I just need to connect the header. And fold it ready for use. Let's get close to the tree now. Okay, let's just move that. Okay. It's very sensitive actually. Acceleration and deceleration. Let's get this lined up. Almost perfectly. Okay, now let's fold it ready for use. Right, now I can see we are totally offline here to actually harvest this, so I'm going to need to reposition. Can't even see it for the trees. I'm going to need to reposition this, but I'm a little bit worried here for the big combine that these trees are going to get in the way. We'll have to just see about that. Okay. Right. Okay. That's down. Okay, let's just put that down. I think we're fairly well. A little bit over the edge, but that's okay. Okay, let's start harvesting this one. Get it going. We are harvesting. Very close to the edge now. Missed a little bit though. And it looks like Helper G. Don't know why she was Helper G, but she's completed her task. Obviously, I'm not sure what the fertilization state of this particular field was, because when I purchased it, it was already almost ready to harvest, so I don't think it's had the three fertilizations. It doesn't look like a lot of crop going into the harvester. But it's not a bad harvest. Very big field this one. Could be extended, I can see. It's widening a little bit. You can get a little bit extra out of it by taking out some of the borders. Oops, missed a bit there. Very close to the edge. Almost at the end. Now, as I remember in Sosnovka before, that there are some trees that get in the way at the ends, as I remember. They're those horrible trees, yes. As I thought. Almost at the first strip. Getting there. As I remember, yes, these trees are going to get in the way, as we can see, which is another reason why I want to get rid of all these trees. things are all just going to get in the way and cause my workers to get stuck on things. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hand this over to a worker, and we'll finish off the fertilisation. So I'll hand it to the worker, who's decided to put the lights on for some reason. Leave it to you. Thanks for that. It would appear that I can go a little bit quicker than he can. If anybody finds a run option, please do let me know, because unlike the other version, I can't find the run. I end up walking everywhere. But maybe there is a run. But I seem to be able to walk faster than he can drive, so don't worry. Let's take a walk back to the other thing. Now, of course, yes, you could use the shortcut switching, and you know, there is an appeal there in doing that, but if you're a real farmer in real life, you don't have that option, so I just like to use reality a little bit. It is a simulator game after all, so so she's finished. What I might just do is move her tractor out of the way first, because then I've got plenty of room to drive back and forth, just to finish off the fertilisation here for this crop. Oh, she's left it down, that's curious. I bet it goes up when I get in. Okay. Indeed. It did. Okay. Well, we've still got some seeds left in it. That's also quite amazing. So, let's just move this out of the way. Leave it there. I will put it away properly, but rather than drive all the way back and walk all the back it back again, let's get back in this machine. Okay. Let's see if we can do it from the interior view this time without hitting the trees, which I did. Static objects, the arch nemesis of the farmer. Okay, let's try that again. Actually, if I just move it over a little bit to the left, I think I can probably do the whole lot in one go. This is so wide. A little bit more. That's looking good. Okay. Let's try and keep it in a straight line then. There's not much there if I go left or right. I'm keeping it in. There. Okay, so job done. Field is fertilized for the second time. Just one more fertilization to go for this one. So let's go put this equipment away. I don't think I can actually see out the back. No, I can't really see out the back, but I can see that I'm a little bit off. Mirrors are not helping either, really. They're absolutely full of machinery, so there, I think that's kind of in. Yes, that's not bad. Right. Let's go get the other tractor. Now, I will at some point perhaps do some multiplayer and actually get some viewers involved as well, because I know there's a lot of people who just enjoy the relaxation of playing the farming game and whatever it may be that they need help with and so on. So I might do that as well, so stay tuned for those. But let's get back in this tractor. Okay, let's go and refill the seeder first. Right, the seeder is now full, and I don't know if you noticed, but when you come over to the seeding area to refill it, it'll automatically take the cover off anyway. So, I'm looking out the wrong side. Let's move back away here. Now, as you can see, when I move away, it puts the cover back on itself. Let's go and put this away. See a lot there. Okay, now I can see a bit better. I am just a tidy worker. Can't see anything. Refill this one while it's here. It'll cost me a little bit. Right, and the next thing to do is just to put this away for now as well. Looks like night's coming. So let's go and put the truck back over there with the animal transportation. I always like to have everything ready to be used again. I can't see out through that window. Not well. I think I'm kind of lined up. That'll do for me. Ready to be used. This is obviously one of the cattle trucks. Obviously you can transport and purchase new animals with it, and obviously sell the ones you have as well. I do think I need to do some thinning out of my tractors. I seem to have gone a little bit crazy buying lots of different kinds of tractors, so I'm probably going to have to get rid of some of those. Although the cap on the slot limit has been increased, it is still, unfortunately, it is still there, and it's actually lower than in the previous game, so that means that you do need to be a bit more tactful with your purchases. So I'm going to have to be a bit more mindful about which things I purchase. But in the meantime, I'm guessing maybe they need emptying. No, still doesn't need emptying. Okay, let's just take this over ready. Probably do some unloading while it's got the lights on. Oh, he's just stopped. Okay. There we go. Okay, so he just stopped. So that was good timing. You can save some fuel by switching it off. Let's take a look in the back. Yeah, filling up quite nicely. They've actually changed some of the ways it fills, mostly because of the tip anywhere, but they're actually working quite nicely. It must be nearly empty, come on. Don't hit me. Let's have a look. 46%. Okay. So he's going to continue to harvest that. He's done pretty much half of it, so it might be another load, and then a little bit maybe before it's all harvested. So then I'm going to need to plough this and move on with this next field. And my next job will also be to get the sheep and the pigs going in the next episode. So that's also what I'm going to be doing. So. That's going to come up in episode 3. In the meantime, I'm going to let this guy finish doing what he's doing, and I'm probably going to be attacking a number of these trees, especially the ones over there behind the other side of the area. And I'm also going to be thinking about how to plan out my farm now that I can purchase more equipment. Some of the placeables I might want to put down, such as the vehicle sheds and such, to put other equipment other places around the map. So I need to figure that one out as well. So I'm going to be figuring that out, cutting down trees and letting this guy finish doing what he's doing. And then I will be back again for another video. So in the meantime, thanks for watching, and I will see you again soon. Thank you.